Hi guys, and welcome to Lizard Studios. Today I'm gonna be making something that's a lot of fun for everyone to do at home, at school, anywhere with friends, what if you have a party, okay? And it's really easy, really simple, very few materials that you need, and it's a lot of fun, and it's gonna be very, very useful. Now, who remembers the story of the three little pigs? One little pig, two little pigs, three little pigs, and the big bad wolf, okay? So this is something that I do at school, usually with my students. We make plays and we make puppets, okay? And with these puppets, we make theater plays in English, and we just practice and we just have fun and play. Well, this is something that you could also do for birthday parties. Maybe if you have a little brother and sister and you have a birthday party and you would like to do something fun with all their friends, we'll take out some materials and I'll show you how to do it, okay? Now, the materials that you need are very easy. You could just get them at any paper store. I'm gonna show you. It's just plain paper, color paper, whatever color that you need for whatever play that you're going to be needing. For example, if you're going to be making the wolf, black paper, some whatever color paper to make like a skirt, the mouth, the teeth. You could also use pom-poms. I'm gonna show you right here, pom-poms. You need, this is important, you need a popsicle stick, a big one, or if you have small ones, also small ones, so you need popsicle sticks. It could be reusable. Look, this one I am reusing. So if you use them for another project, you're not using it anymore, you could reuse things again also, okay? Here I have my whole entire collection of papers that I've been using for other projects, but I don't throw them away. I also have these two eyes that I just made out of white paper, and with a marker, I just colored the eyeballs on, okay? And I'm going to be using them for today's project, okay? So you need markers, and you need scissors for little hands or big scissors for bigger hands, okay? Now, I wanted to show you before we begin some of the puppets that my students have made, which are really, really beautiful. And for example, this little girl here next to me, guess who she is? That's right, Beauty from Beauty and the Beast. And then we have here this beautiful, I thought it was just wonderful, the way this penguin plays the guitar. Okay, so I just had to put him here today. And I also have Little Red Riding Hood right here. This was one that one of my students made. And I think it's just gorgeous also. And a little chick that I made. This is what we're gonna be making today. Okay, I'll just show you how to make this very special dude. Okay, and then I have here Robin Hood. Oh my goodness. How many times have we seen the movies? Well, here he is. And so let's begin, okay? Okay, so the first thing that you need is just a plain piece of paper, whatever color. If you're gonna make a fish, maybe you want a blue piece of paper. If you're gonna make a turtle, maybe you would like a green piece of paper. Maybe if you're gonna make, I don't know, a flamingo, pink, okay? Well, you can make any color you want. I mean, it's all a matter of creativity. Okay, so what I'm gonna do first is take my glue stick and I am going to make a tube just to give it a body, just to give our project a body. Okay, and I'm gonna turn it around. And I am going to glue it. Just hold it for 10 seconds. Hold it down for 10 seconds. And it will be glued, okay? Now I'm using a whole entire piece of paper. Maybe if you have smaller siblings or if you have small students, maybe you want to use like a fourth of a paper or half a paper. And this also works. All you have to do is glue it in the back and then you have your little tube. Okay, very simple, all right? But I'm gonna be using this big one so you guys could see how it's working out, all right? So, first thing that we do, we're gonna begin with the face. Now, I'm gonna be using these eyes that I already made. Now remember, if you are making whatever it is that you're making, the face, the eyes have got to be looking the same way. If not, it's gonna be like a chameleon, one looking one way and the other one looking the other way. So make sure that you know what you're making and where your eyes, you want your eyes to go, because you could put your eyes looking downward or you could put your eyes looking upward. So just remember where your eyes are going to look and put them looking both the same way, okay? And that will be, you know, something to take care of when you're doing your artwork, all right? So you put your eyes on, and then what I have done is I already made a little beak here, but I wanted to show you how to make it. So to make a little beak, it's really simple. All you have to do is cut a square just like this out of a piece of paper, and you fold it in half, corner to corner, okay? And sometimes it's not perfectly cut, okay? It doesn't match evenly because we're not perfect. Nobody's perfect, so this is not gonna match. All you have to do is cut again on the line like this, okay? And then you would have a little perfect beak, okay, to glue on. Maybe you could put some nostrils here. So this is where the marker comes in. And you put your two little nostrils, okay? And you add some glue to the back. And you add your beak. You just glue your beak on your little. Now, once you have put your beak on your chick, what you could do is start adding, for example, some feathers that you have, you know, from around the house. It could be any color feather. I had this cute little yellow feathers, so I thought I would use these. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna make two little wings, you know, really cute. So I'm gonna add some glue stick. Glue stick is wonderful because you just hold it for 10 seconds and look, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Well, that was more like 5 seconds. Don't tell anyone, my timing is a little bit off. Okay, and then you put more glue on this side and look at this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And it's two perfect wings. And then you could also add like this one here, you see? I put some feathers also on the top. So you could just maybe add a little feather on the top and it'll be really cute. Okay, so just, you know, let creativity flow. Let your students or you let your children or let, you know, your friends just decorate this however they want. Here I have some pipe cleaners that I hadn't mentioned before because I have all these sort of things all around my studio. So just, you know, you could take pipe cleaners also and you can make like a little dress. Okay, pipe cleaners are great because you could just fold them in the back and then add a little bit of tape, and then that will be that. That will be done. Okay. So here we go. Let me close that up really well so it won't fall back down. So here we go. Oh my god. Oh my god. Poor chick. I put his feather down. Hold on. Oh, now he could fly again. All right. Okay, you're good? You're good, dude? Good. So there he is. And now what I did on this one is I put like little trousers or like a little kind of skirt on him. You could take any color you want. You can make it orange, you can make it red. I'm gonna make this one red. You can make some polka dots, for example, here. I wanna make some polka dots, so let me show you how to make some really quick and really simple. You just fold a paper up like this, you fold it again. And what you do is you just draw circles. Just draw circles. They don't have to be straight or perfect or anything like that. You just draw a bunch of them, just having fun, because this project to have fun with. And you just cut around. Remember, the scissors always stay straight. You open and close them. Okay, this is the way we cut. I always show my students the scissors always open and close. And what we do is we drive on the road. We turn the circle all the way around. Now, this is talent, okay? Because I'm not even looking at the line. So if it's coming out all right, it's just amazing, okay? Look at that, almost perfect. Well, you know what? It doesn't matter if it didn't come out perfect because I could just turn it around, put some glue on it, and no, it's my secret. Okay, so there's lots of things like this that you could do, all right? Let's see. So we're just gonna make this one a flamenco girl. She's gonna be dancing some flamenco. So she's gonna be a flamenco chick. I don't like this one because the marker came out in the back. So what am I gonna do with this? Just throw it away, okay? I'll just take another one that I like. And I'm gonna put these polka dots all over my chick. Okay, so I'm gonna just keep on taking more polka dots, putting them on, so you get the idea, right? So this is the way you do this. Now, once you have your puppet, what you do is you take your popsicle stick, okay? The ones that you, you know, eat the ice creams with. All right, it could be any color, colorful ones, or really, like the doctor one would be okay. You know, whoever, if you go to the doctor, just ask him, oh, can I keep it? And then you have a little collection of them and just use them for crafts. So I'm just gonna put this down. I'm gonna get some glue, okay? Put some glue on it. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put it right in the back of the puppet. Okay, I'm gonna measure the back more or less. It's not always gonna be right on where you glued it. So just glue that on, and then to reinforce it, what do you do? Because remember, the children are gonna be playing with this, and they really play with these things. So I'm gonna put a little bit of sellotape also in the back, okay, like this. See, you stick the sellotape here, you press it down like that, okay, and that just holds it there. And now we could have a chick parade or a little puppet show, okay, with all our little characters here on the table, okay? To this, remember, you could always add stars, you could add pom-poms for the legs. If you want some legs, you know, you could put some pom-poms here, or you could add anything you have at home that you would like to add, you could put it on here also, okay? And have this wonderful, wonderful, wonderful puppets for your puppet shows, for your puppet plays, for your birthday parties. So I really hope you enjoyed today's video, okay? You could do this at home, you could do it at school, tell everyone about it, okay? And if you like the video, please hit like and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this one, okay? See you soon, guys. I love you. Mwah. Have a great day.